Hey guys, welcome to the Lux channel. So every time I get emails from my clients across the world, one of the things which they complain, which they are facing in their networks is network latency issues and apart from packet drops and stuff like that. So often these customers or clients are having satellite based WAN networks and due to which what is happening is due to the limitation of physics and due to the limitation of technology, you know, latency is something which, you know, something is a kind of one of the critical attribute or parameter with which they are getting a degraded WAN performance. So if you compare UDP and you know, TCP based protocol communication, one can understand UDP gives a sort of linear performance curve. So if you have 100 milliseconds latency network and if you have 200 milliseconds latency network, UDP is almost going to scale this up linearly. So and 100 milliseconds you know, latency based WAN network is going to have half of the issues than one can experience with the 200 milliseconds. This is not the case with TCP based you know, connections, because TCP is going to amplify this effect, and even with a slight increase of latency as that you know, each, you know, network goes on, I mean, you have multiple network carriers and each network carrier has a different sort of you know, latency involved. So as it changes this, you know, parameter, the TCP is going to amplify this situation and it is going to give completely a different performance curve. So this is an issue which one have to bear with the TCP network. So to demonstrate the same, what I have is I have this child's abacus. This is not the Japanese variant which often been used in schools and stuff like that. So this is much you know, used, you know, as a part of child's learning curve so that they can understand how to do counting and stuff like this. So we can visualize any device based QoS with the colors of you know, beads over here. You can imagine each of these bead represents a network packet. So you have a WAN gateway, you can imagine you have a QoS, you have some kind of QoS strategy, you have your you know, regular traffic classified as a specific queue. This can be your HTTP or HTTPS based, you know, packets and the queue of the same, and this can be your VoIP packet, and this can be, you know, some kind of additional you know, classification can be done. So like this you have much higher priority, lower priority and much bandwidth based queue. So you can even visualize, and some cases you can even visualize, you can use, you know, an aid like this, and we can visualize each of this bar or this string. This looks almost like this musical instrument harp. So each, you know, bar, we can assume it's like a WAN link, and you have all this packets in, you know, waiting in the queue, packet queue. So what happens is to address latency, only thing which we can do is we can do something called as packet multiplexing or packet coalescing, because latency is something which you have to the only option to deal with latency is just to you know, hop on to some other provider in case if you have the choice. And if you are the ISP or if you are the, you know, satellite infrastructure provider, you have to upgrade your equipment. There is nothing we can much do about. But however, having said that, what happens is if you have any WAN device, WAN optimization device, in case if you are building any WAN optimization strategy, the only option you can do to address latency, apart from you know, file queuing and file caching and stuff like that, I'm not getting over that, but I'm getting into that core packet level optimization. So in that case, only thing which you can do is something called as packet multiplexing. So assume you have these packets in the queue. You have this particular packet which is around 1500 bytes, which is near to the MTU. What you can do is you can send it as it is, and followed by which, assume in this queue you have a TCP ACK packet, and right after that you have some sort of a VoIP packet to be sent. So in this case, assume this VoIP packet is around 200-250 bytes, and this is a TCP ACK, so it is not much going to be bigger. So in that case, assume all these packets are destined to the same destination, and then from there it is getting distributed, or else it can be a situation like two offices connected via this WAN link, it can be a branch office to the head office or two branch offices and stuff like that. So in that case, what you can do is you can merge these two packets and you can send it as it is, as it. So this way what happens is you have to deal with the same latency, but you can reduce the overall overhead of transportation of these packets. So there is also a case you can even merge, you know, more packets together. Assume each of these are, you know, subsequent VoIP packets. There is a case, assume you have multiple users in one office to other office connected, and some scenario they are having you know, VoIP based conference, and there are two teams, they are doing a simultaneous conference. So in that case, and the device may get your you know, network gateway or CPE or router may get, you know, multiple packets. So in such a case, assume these are all waiting in the queue. So when you pick these packets to the transmit, so each time a router, what it does is it is going to get this it is going to take this packet from the queue, and then it is going to transmit, and then it is going to take the next packet, it is going to transmit. So this is what essentially happens in IP forward, in IPv4 forwarding context, like a router of Linux router. And essentially same thing happens in BR forward in switching context. So let's assume it is IPv4 routing context. So in that case, what happens is it is going to get this packet, it is going to do a forward, and then it is going to do the forward, and then next it is going to get this packet, it is going to do the forward. So in that case, instead of doing this, we can adopt or implement packet multiplexing. So in that case, what you can do is it's going to get this packet, and then if it is near empty, we can just send it as it is, and next it can see if this packet is somewhere like, you know, 100 or 200 bytes, it can wait, or it can see what is the next subsequent packet, and it is around another 100 or 200 bytes, it can just, you know, combine these two packets and it can send it in one single packet. So this way what happens is you don't have to you can mitigate some amount of negative effects of, you know, network latency. So in this way, you can also have a choice. If the queue is quite longer, obviously it is going to be because you have a big difference between your LAN network and your WAN network, because LAN is at the order of gigabit or else 100 Mbps or stuff like that, whereas your you know, WAN network, even if it is around 50 Mbps or so, there is a huge amount of, you know, potential difference involved in this case. So in that case, what you can do is you can also see if there are subsequent packets. One can be a TCP ACK, one can be a, you know, VoIP packet, and one can be some sort of HTTP GET, and something else, it can be another TCP ACK or TCP SYN or TCP RESET packet. So you can combine all these two together, and if it is nearly 1400 bytes, it can send it in one go. So this way it can do packet multiplexing, as long as these multiplexed packets are not, you know, exceeding the MTU limit. So this way you can mitigate some amount of latency issues. And other than that, what you can see is Google is experimenting, or Google have this quick protocol. So this is something, it is going to be happening only if they have, if you have complete your own infrastructure. So the essential idea behind quick protocol is they are using UDP instead of SSL communications. A quick protocol is a sort of application layer SSL what they have done, and apart from that, they have also done congestion control, everything on top of the UDP. So this way they pulled up the core critical components which happens in TCP protocol, which is pulled up all the way to the application layer, so that, you know, it is much more optimized. And this way they have that linear performance curve, unlike, you know, being dependent on, you know, TCP to transfer your bulk of the data. It can be even file download, it can be any such kind of communication path. So this is how you know, Google is experimenting. So even now, if you use Google Chrome browser, so you can capture these packets in Wireshark. You can find that it will be, most of the cases it will be using quick as its communication protocol. Whenever it, you know, communicates with Google's remote servers and Google's infrastructure, so you can you know, sniff these packets and you can find it out. It will be using the quick, you know, application layer protocol. So this way, latency is something which we really can't address in a simple terms. So although there are other providers say that, you know, they can do file caching and stuff like that. The file caching can happen only if it is something like a file format. What happens to the VoIP traffic? What happens to your live streaming traffic or else live voice chat? So what happens to those kind of packets when it is combined with your offline services or offline traffic, like any passive file download or something like that? So the problem is not about something. These are the things which you will never notice if it is something happening in your LAN network, because in your LAN network you may have some sort of a communication, like almost like peer to peer. I may have a couple of servers over here in my office, and I may be uploading or downloading a file, and my colleague will be uploading and downloading a file from some other server. So almost this happens like a peer to peer fashion and without any sort of single channel involved. Whereas if you do through your WAN links, and this is where the problem starts, because what is happening over here is all these packets are getting converged to the single gateway, and it has to communicate through this single gateway, and this is where it gets amplified, and this is where you need to wait so that assume your colleague is uploading a file and I'm trying to download a file or upload a file simultaneously. What happens is all these packets have to be queued up, and then one after another it has to pass through. So effectively your gateway is also going to address congestion by dropping the packets, because it's just cannot keep sending the packets, because it has to also have this flow control implemented. And effectively, since the packet is not going, it is once the input queue is filled, assume this is your input queue is filled, once the queue is filled, all the gateways or your router, so it is going to do is it is just going to drop these packets. And since it has dropped this packet, your devices in your LAN network, it is going to do a retransmit. So this way what happens is, in the case of TCP, it is going to amplify this situation, and then you are going to continue to get degraded performance. Whereas in the case of UDP, it is not the case, because with the application layer protocols, you can implement congestion control and other stuff on application layer protocol, and this way you can optimize your network performance. Whereas in the case of TCP, you cannot do that as such, because it's just done based on the technology evolved at that point of time. Whereas with the modern equipment and modern infrastructure what you have, TCP is quite outdated. So I hope you guys liked watching this video. In case if you have any questions regarding network latency or network optimization, you can discuss in YouTube comments, or else you can send me an email across. So thank you once again for watching this video, guys. Have a nice day. Bye bye.